Now then, where do we start? There was, we'll start with Life with Elizabeth.
I'd love to.
Yeah, which started in Hollywood in 19...
Well, actually, we were on 2 years live before we went on film. We went on film in 1952, so that makes it somewhere around 1950 that we started live. But it was fun because we had the, our idea of making the three vignettes in the half hour was that you'll tell something funny that happens to you, you know, to your husband or to you, and it'll hold up and be very funny for 5 or 6 minutes, but if you try to attenuate it into a half hour, it gets a little draggy and a little skinny in spots. So we do three of them in the half hour, incident number one, incident number two, and incident number three. So if you bombed out on two of them even, you might come back strong with a third.
Went on one. Mm-hmm. So yes, Elwood.
Was it scripted or partly ad-lib, Betty?
In the beginning, it was scripted when we were on film, but in the beginning when we were on live, I was also doing a 5.5 hour a day, 6 day a week show. So we didn't have a lot of rehearsal time. And we would kind of know where we were going and what the situation was and a few key gags. And then Alvin was played by Del Moore, and he and I were crazy about each other, and we were both crazy. So we would kind of improvise from point to point. But once in a while, you can dry up on that, too.
Any famous goofs?
Oh, tell them about that one, the live one.
We were on live, and as I say, if one would dry up, the other usually could bail him out or bail me out. But one night, I looked at him, and he looked at me, and we were both just glassy-eyed. Nothing was happening on a grand scale, and we both knew it, and it was a restaurant sketch. So he looked at me for a minute, and he said, "Oh, excuse me, Elizabeth," and he got up and walked out and just left me there in front of the audience, in front of the camera. So I'm making little mountains out of sugar cubes, and I'm stacking the salt and pepper shakers, and actually, I was having such a grand little show all by myself, I was kind of sorry to see him come back with the line.
Excuse me, you just said... While you were doing that, you were also doing a 5.5 hour, 6 day a week show?
Yes, sir. That was in Los Angeles.
You are mad. What were you doing?
Well, I was money hungry. But no, this was back in
yes,
the very
you were. Go ahead.
Beginning of television, yeah. And it was a joyous experience. It was like going to college to learn television, because everything that could possibly happen happened on camera.
But what was the 5.5 hour a day show?
It was a variety guest interview type show on the old KLAC station. In Los Angeles, it was either the test pattern or us, and some of the people like the test pattern.
It's still on, incidentally. Your show's off, but the test pattern is still on.
I know it.
But you should know that.
Miss White, in your career,
Miss Betty.
Betty. You've won so many awards. Of which one are you most proud?
Well, the most exciting one was the Emmy, I must admit, because it was completely unexpected, and one of those nights that you've just never forget. I was sitting there. I had gone to the dinner. I didn't have any better sense. And all of a sudden, I heard them get around to the category, and I was all sitting back just completely sure it was going to be somebody else, but your heart starts to go like this, and then I heard my own name. And I think I cried for 3 days. You know how you do. But it was delightful.
Something about winning an Emmy, it's often said, I think, by people who win an Oscar, that often it doesn't do their career any good in the long run. Would you have the same opinion about the Emmy? Probably not.
Well, I really don't know. Actually, in my phase of the business, I had done Life with Elizabeth for those years, and then I did a daytime variety show, and then another situation comedy, all of which tied me down completely. So then I started to freelance and discovered this great new world where you could kind of call your shots as far as the time that you worked. You could work on game shows or special events or whatever, and still have some free time. So the Emmy actually helped me in a sense, mm-hmm. because it gave a little background that you might not have otherwise.
Sort of set you free.
A little bit.
I read, I think it was in Variety last summer, that you and your husband together as an attraction in summer stock sold more tickets at the box office than practically any other of the summer shows.
Well, we've been so lucky, Anna, really. We just keep waiting for it to stop. But I think the fact that we were married, it'll be 3 years in June, and everybody sort of saw the romance start and kind of worked it out with us, and everybody comes up to us and says, "Well, I was the one that, when I saw you two, I said they ought to get married," and I was the one who said that. Of course, we get that, you know, from everybody. So I think for that reason, they kind of like to come see us in summer stock or winter stock now that we're doing. So we've been awfully lucky in working together. It's worked out. We've done several musicals. We're going to go to St. Louis and Kansas City this summer with Bells Are Ringing. Oh. So let's just hope the romance still, you know, lasts in people's hearts enough to have them buy more tickets.
We can always see you or Alan on Password, and then we see you from Pasadena every New Year's Day. And now we've got you on flashback. We're very lucky. Thank you for joining us.
Well, I've enjoyed it, and happy Easter, everybody.
Thank you. It's been a delightful visit, and you're a beauty for Easter Day.